And Milwaukee Police Chief Ed Flynn will release numbers showing a dramatic drop in crime in our city. The statistics focus on crimes committed in the first 3 months of the year. New at 10 tonight, 12 News' Mike Gousha is here with the story behind the numbers.
Toya, some people may wonder if the crime numbers are down because of our harsh winter weather this year, or as Chief Flynn referred to it, Chief Deputy Jack Frost. But when police took a closer look at the numbers and saw that calls were up compared to last year, they concluded that something else was at work.
I think it's important for people to know that things are improving. We've seen some extraordinary trends in homicide downward. Robbery trends are very much downward. Stolen car trends are downward. And significantly for this city, aggravated assaults, which are the serious assaults with guns and knives, are also down.
That's welcome and reassuring news to young Milwaukee mom Amy Deliberti.
We love the city, basically. We really love it. But yeah, there are concerns, but I'm sure it's pretty similar to any big city.
Westside resident and architect Robert Zimmerman agrees.
Me, I've never not felt safe anywhere.
But don't try telling that to Northside resident Julio Calle.
In my clinic, we had our cars broken into like every other day last summer, and people getting beat up, and no, I don't feel safe at all.
In the war on crime, perception is reality. An enemy, Chief Flynn says, is tough to defeat, especially with daily news coverage of crime.
When I talked to you earlier this year, you said numbers are important, but they're only part of the story. The other part of the story is, do people feel safer? Mm-hmm. What are you hearing from people?
Well, I'm not sure people are feeling safer yet. And the irony is that at a time when nationally crime is at the lowest levels in American history, media coverage of crime is at its highest levels. And so sometimes it's difficult, particularly in a place like Milwaukee that does have some significant violence in certain aspects of town, to counter the daily dose of yellow crime seat story with the big picture of trends are down, more people are living, fewer people are getting shot, fewer people are getting robbed. So I'm not sure where we need to be on the fear issue. I do think people are noticing an enhanced police presence.
Northside resident John Roby says he's noticed more cops on the street.
I see more police, they're all over.
But Southsider Jose Gonzalez doesn't see it that way.
When you really need the police, you don't even find one, you know, around you, and you even call and you'll be waiting forever.
Chief Flynn says the response time issue is a challenge, especially since the community calls on the police department to meet a wide variety of needs.
If somebody's bleeding, not breathing, or actively being assaulted, that's a priority one call, and I want to be there right now just like you want us to be there. But every call is not equally important. You know, we become the social service agency of first resort for everybody. We've allowed ourselves between cell phones and police radios to basically be taken out of the public spaces of Milwaukee. People say, oh, I never see a cop when I need one. Well, that's true because everybody is in somebody's living room giving them advice. Not in a life and death situation, telling them how to do something to take care of themselves. In this room, every year, 800,000 calls come in. There's only 600,000 people in the city. All right, and everybody is expecting a police officer right now. But do the math, can't happen. And it can't happen if we're also trying to prevent crimes and restore order to public places.
That's why Flynn is experimenting with new approaches. He's assigned officers on short-term disability to take calls from residents with non-emergency needs. He's also eliminating last summer's much-touted but time-limited neighborhood safety initiative in favor of neighborhood policing on a year-round basis.
We are relentlessly focusing on neighborhood conditions. We're community-based, we're problem-oriented, we're data-driven.
So far, Flynn's efforts are drawing praise from people inside and outside of City Hall.
I've embraced the things that he's implemented, and as we move into the summer months, it's nice to know that things are working well so far.
I think he's had a great start. I think it's too short a time period over which to have any accurate measurement.
And that's an observation Chief Flynn would probably agree with. Now, the chief and Mayor Barrett did not want to release the numbers until they briefed the Common Council tomorrow. But we did our own comparison on the murder rate for the first 3 months. That shows nearly a 50% decrease from a year ago. The crime stats become public at 6 o'clock tomorrow night. Toya?
Now, Mikey, so the chief is eliminating last summer's neighborhood safety initiative. I guess the big question would be, why?
Well, he says it's not because the program wasn't a success. It did help reduce crime somewhat last summer. But when the program ended, crime went right back up again. And Flynn prefers what he says is more of a year-round strategy, uses hard data, hard numbers, and input from his district commanders to respond specifically to trouble spots. So there won't be a new program this summer, but a continuation of the steps that have been taken in the first 3 months.
All right. Very interesting. We look forward to the rest. Thank you, Mike.